What's going on, guys? In this video, I'm going to show you how you can create any type of equation in PowerPoint in just a couple of seconds. So without further ado, let's get started. All right, so as you can see here, I just have a blank background and there's nothing added yet. But what you can do is to add a simple equation to any PowerPoint. So you can go here and they have pre-made equations here for you. But let's say you're not finding the equation that you might like. You can go here to ink equation and then you can actually write out the type of equation you would like. So let's say you're just in math class or whatever. This may be even not math class. This may be any type of use case, physics, science, anything. You can write it out here. So let's say you want cos, trying to add the best handwriting possible for this.
6.5 hours later.
There we go. Okay, so if you have bad handwriting, this is actually gonna be terrible for you guys. But no, all seriousness, this is a quick way to make any type of formula that you may have. And you can actually keep going with this if you want to add more to it. And that's super sloppy, apologies, but. And then you could keep going down. It just keeps populating more and more. Okay, that is not a Z. I don't know why I keep using twos. Let's try a three here. All right. I'm not sure if this is even an equation really. Breaking out my old math skills. All right, now let's times this by 7,200. Okay, it thinks it's 79,000. So, okay, there's a couple of bugs with it, but for the most part, I think it's very accurate, especially if you have a lot better handwriting. I could even try erases because I have a touch screen, so let me just try drawing it with my hand on the screen. Let's see. All right, start fresh. 1/2 / 3. Okay, so if you have a touch screen, this actually works beautifully, okay? Should have done that to start. But if you don't have a touch screen, just try your best with your trackpad to write it. All right, so now if you want to try out this feature called select and correct, here what you can do is you can do 4 + 4 = we'll just pretend and say it's 5, even though we all know it's not. Or do we? No, I'm just kidding. All right, then we can select and correct. So if I highlight this, now, what you can do is, let's say it's not the actual type of symbol you want, you can go in here and change it, which is a very cool feature. It'll try to guess what other options there are. So let's say when I was creating that 2, it actually was supposed to be a 2 originally. So let's try that again. Let's see. I do 2, select correct. Okay, now it draws 2. But you understand the point with select a correct answer, that if you are wanting to change a certain thing, all you have to do is hold and circle around it, and they'll suggest the other options that you might have been trying to actually write out. All right, and then if you want to clear everything, you can do clear. You can always increase and decrease the sides. So let's say, now that I wrote out that equation, I actually want to add it to the slides. So let's say I wrote something, we can do 1 + 2/x + 4² squared. Okay, well, whatever that is. And then we can insert. Now it just types it out for you. You don't even have to worry about inserting certain symbols. You can increase it. You can also still change the font size of it and yeah, change color and everything. And then you can go in here and edit if you didn't want that. So that is a quick way on how to create different equations in PowerPoint. I hope you found this entertaining as I was struggling a little bit, but it's a very cool tool. And in order to find this tool again, all you have to do is go to insert, equation, and then ink equation, and that is how you can add in any equation in PowerPoint. So if you did like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up, and if you could subscribe, I would greatly appreciate it. Also, if you are interested in learning more about PowerPoint, I'm actually offering a course on Udemy right now for 90% off, so you can just check out the links in the description below for that. Lastly, if you did like this video, make sure to let me know in the comments, and let me know what you guys may be looking for next. I love to explore all the different features within PowerPoint and try to have a creative element to it. So I'm happy to create any type of videos you guys might be looking for. So without further ado, I hope you guys have a great rest of your day, and I hope to see you guys in the next video. Thanks.